Hi everyone, my name is Dee Dee and welcome to Mafia 3. Yes, it's here. It's one of the games that I've been looking forward to playing at the end of 2016. It has been released today, so I am going to get stuck into it, give it some gameplay, all that sort of good stuff. To be honest though, I'm having to cut and splice the music somewhat. It's a bit of a pain in the ass because Jimi Hendrix, All Along the Watchtower, is playing at the intro, and it's one of the most amazing songs ever. It's probably one of my favourite Jimi Hendrix songs, but unfortunately, due to the Hendrix record group policy, it's muted the whole video. So all of the audio for the whole video is gone if I use Jimi Hendrix All Along the Watchtower in it. I'm going to keep all the other songs in that don't just destroy the audio, and they can make money and monetize my video out of that. So hence why I'm talking this little bit ad lib, and we'll literally cut back into the video now. Right. Oh, the scenario, I guess it's loading. So I think I'm just gonna play this for like an hour and then see what you guys think. Tell me if there's obviously things that you want to see, want me to do, got any questions, blah 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 blah, my overall thoughts. I haven't played it yet, so I'm not going to do a critique or review. I'll probably do some like tips and some tricks and things to do type of videos to try and help you out as I'm playing it. I have in the game that it came in, the game in the box that the game comes with, it does have this a map, and I'll try and put that on the screen now if I can find someone on. But it's huge. This is like, it's obviously so much like GTA. It's pretty cool. 1968. We sought to create an authentic and immersive experience that captures the very turbulent time and place, including depictions of racism. Oh dear. We find racist beliefs, language, and behaviours of some characters in the game abhorrent. I think that's the way you say it, but I believe it is vital to include some depictions in order to tell Lincoln Clay's story. Most importantly, we felt that it was not to include this very real shameful past and offensive blah blah blah. I can't read that fast. I'm coming. This music. Oh man. Witness.
New Bordeaux. A modern city with traditional Southern values.
I underestimated how far he was going to go. What he was willing to do.
Visit the historic French Ward and enjoy local cuisine at one of our five-star restaurants.
Killing them wasn't enough. Lincoln Clay was using them to send a message.
Or spend the afternoon in the bayou and take in its natural splendor.
Sal Marcano had no idea what he was going to unleash.
New Bordeaux. Safe. Family-oriented fun. Make it your next vacation destination.
This city survived the War of 1812, the Civil War, and God knows how many hurricanes. But when Lincoln Clay went after the mob, he inflicted more damage than all the wars and hurricanes combined. Oh,
yeah. There he is. Lincoln Clay, I'm loving the soundtrack.
Lincoln's mother abandoned him in 1947, a couple of years after he was born. His mother, I heard she was Dominican. I always figured his father was white, maybe even Italian. Not that it mattered. Back then, if you look black, you black. Same as today, I suppose. He stayed at the orphanage until 1958.
Now, when did you meet Lincoln Clay?
1966. I was running black ops out of Laos on behalf of the CIA. He was loaned out to me via joint CIA-DOD task force.
He was a quiet boy. Good boy.
Two Purple Hearts, a Bronze Star, and the Distinguished Service Cross. He served his country with honor and distinction.
After the city closed the orphanage, he fell in with Sammy Robinson. Sammy ran the black mob over in Delray Hollow. I can't say I approved, but often colored boys didn't have a lot of options back then. Boys like Lincoln, ones who've been abandoned, they're always looking for a home. Always looking for a place to belong.
think he thought he'd find an army. Thing is, once that's lost, you can never get it back again. When he returned from the war, Lincoln ended back up over at Sammy's. Now Sammy owed the Italian mob a whole lot of money, and he needed Lincoln's help. It's a damn shame what happened. It breaks my heart.
Ooh. What breaks your heart? What happened? What? What's going on? It's kind of interesting that, you know, the 2K developers have decided that... What's he doing here?
Still say this is the craziest goddamn thing I ever heard. Using real money to rob the feds.
Well, hell, man, not like this is our cash. This all came from Skeletta. Besides, peanuts compared to what we're gonna haul out of there.
Is everything we need to burn?
Yeah, that's it. I grab the keys to the truck, then we can get the fuck out of here.
Wanna take the chance? Let's pick up the keys. Here I am, check me out. Is that a security guard? I guess it's a security guard.
Keys in the other room. Grab them so we can get the hell out of here.
All right. Let's go that way. I presume you can run somehow. Oh, ninja moves. Sorry, I'm probably making you feel sick now. How do you run then?
Hey man, let's grab those keys.
There must be a run. This is like get under cover. Huah. Sneaky. then crouch stealthy style.
Still not sure about leaving him like this.
He came through with the truck just like we asked. We could grease his partner to make it look good. But if you got doubts, why take the chance?
So, I'm a dodgy security guard. Oh, I can pick this dude up.
Lincoln, pick up the keys.
No. I've got him. I've got the keys. Is that the keys? I'll chuck him on there. Oh, what can I do here? Oh!
All right then, that's that. God damn.
No witnesses.
Hey man, grab those.
I guess that was the right thing to do if you don't want to get caught. From a humanitarian perspective, not so much. Just make sure he's dead. And you as well. You never be sure. It's the assassination method.
Get going. You got the keys so you can drive.
No, thanks very much.
Come on, let's get the hell out of here.
Let's get the hell out of here. Feed a gator. Can I feed a gator? Any gators? Two chickens, 75 cents. Right, come on then. We seem to have robbed these bros.
Let's go, man. The clock's ticking.
Forward. Okay, this isn't the particularly most fast of vehicles. Oh, a nice little sign. Thanks very much.
Take it easy heading to town. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses. My old man wanted us to keep one of the guards alive, help throw the feds off the trail.
Oh.
Like you said, I take a chance. Besides, if I learn anything from being over in Nam, someone's willing to flip sides once, they're probably willing to do it a second time. Fuck you in the process.
Fuck you.
So answer me this. What's the craziest thing you saw over there?
You don't want to know.
Hell, man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Oh, Georgie Marcano pays taxes.
Damn right I do. That's how they got Al Capone, and I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill. Huh? Well, you going to answer the question or what?
We on the coast of Quang Nai. Evacuating the cities before Charlie overran everything.
Sorry about
anyway,
that.
Anyway, we getting him onto a medical ship, and this woman walks up. She got a baby in one hand, and the leash to a pig in the other. She starts up the ramp, and the MP stops and tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby into the water. MP goes ape, tells someone dive in after the kid, starts screaming at the woman, wants to know what the fuck she's thinking. You know what she says to him? She says, I can always have another baby.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Hey, man, you asked.
Yeah, but I thought you were going to tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, God damn.
It's not a fault. But not like you think. The conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day, you're raising cattle, tending your rice. Next day, everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall, they will do anything to survive.
That better have been one delicious fucking pig.
Right, well, this game is definitely no mercy, is it? I've already shot someone in the head. He's telling stories about babies being chucked into rivers. But he plays good music. Sorry, did I used to do that? And the graphics are pretty sweet. I seem to be doing 90 kilometers an hour in a massive security truck through downtown, and no one really cares. Oh yeah. Change. Handbrake it. Is that a handbrake?
Dodge is the reserve.
No, not so much.
Won't be too keen on you waltzing around with that piece of yours.
Well,
I'll just leave it under the seat.
What's going on with this guy? They're having a fight. Massive head fight. Who are these dudes?
Time to see if these forged IDs are worth a fuck.
Wow, there's some sketchy people around. Well, that was a nice drive, wasn't it?
Back it up to the loading dock.
Some of these fellas might get a little rough with the language and...
Well, ain't like I never been called nigger before.
Nah, I know, but I'm just saying, if I go along with it, ain't nothing personal.
The only thing I care about is getting our hands on that money.
Exit the vehicle. So I thought the cutscene was still going.
When I say something about being hot, that's when we make our move.
All right.
Hang on a sec. You said don't carry around
here we go.
Your piece. There you are with a shotgun.
Put your IDs up the glass.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
What the fuck's this shit heel doing here?
Affirmative action. You know how it is.
Old country is spinning around a goddamn toilet.
Harsh. Harsh words.
You can follow me. As for you, go on and grab those bags off the truck. You'll be carrying them to the burning room. How much y'all bring in?
$238,546. Small bills, mostly.
Ugh.
I'll have Miss Gale call up to your office when we're done. She'll confirm the delivery.
Appreciate it.
Hello.
Yeah, check that scatter gun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
You can pick it up on the way out.
I'm not gonna smack him with these sacks of cash in a minute.
Room's down in the cellar. This way. I ain't seen y'all around these parts before.
Y'all's over in Georgia for a while. He just got out the service.
And my cousin's been trying to get on here for over a year now.
Was in the Navy for two tours. Got medals falling out of his ass. Government tells him thanks, but no thanks.
That's a crock of shit if I ever heard one.
Sad day when a God-fearing white man can't get a job. It ain't your nigga who staggers in his hide on the spot. You bastards better not be playing with each other back there.
What's up with this guy's head?
Fuck you! Christ, look at that. Didn't know y'all held that motto.
All right, mate.
It's been shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, then it gets sent to Dallas, then it comes back. It doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense.
Right, that's endgame, isn't it? I want you. I want gold. All the gold! I'm still quite gonna work out if we're stealing money, making money.
Put those bags on the table there.
Burning money. Doing something with money.
Figured it'd be bigger.
I guess the job done. Only time there's a problem is when the flue clogs up.
Fuck, that's some heat right there.
Used to use coal for it, but a year or so back we switched over to oil. Maintains a more consistent flame.
Here's some guy come around the house trying to
silent takedowns.
Told him I wasn't interested.
I never was neither till I saw this. At least with oil, we don't get soot all over the goddamn place. Used to be we'd have a nigga come in with a hose, wash all the shit up.
I think he said the N-word a bit too much. Oh, no! Yeah, he definitely said the N-word too much.
That was an asshole.
We need to move. Danny and Ellis should be coming up any time now.
Give me a second.
There's a guard right there, dude. What are you doing?
You take care of those guards. Keep your ass down. You don't want them getting a drop on us.
Okay. I know what the fuck I'm doing.
I am fucking exhausted.
Take cover.
You know that house we've been renting out?
Called. Why do I do this?
Last night. Told them I wanted to see. Told them they needed to get out in 2 weeks. And the man, his name's John. He's laying into me.
Saying the lease
gives them the right to a 30-day notice. That's how he's supposed to find a new place in 2 weeks. So I tell him none of that's my god.
Shut up. Oh, there's a massive machine gun. LB or hold LB or LB. I want to get in there. I could do the silence jobber though.
Get over here, man.
All right. Well, okay. You don't crouch, I'll crouch. So hang on, I'm meant to move down sights.
We need to get this vault open.
No, we need to get that open so I can get the M60 in there. Please. Alright.
Oh, I hope this combination skeleto got us is legit.
He looks like John Cusack, that guy. Sort of.
Well, no, I'll be damned. Alright, go for it, Godzilla.
Godzilla? He's a big fella, I suppose.
Holy fucking shit!
It's beautiful. All right, I'm gonna take care of this room. You see what you can get from outside. Once these boys punch you with that drill, we're gonna start throwing this down.
Yeah, I'm not really sure how they're gonna get the money out, to be fair.
God damn it! You triggered the fucking alarm?
Shit, I didn't notice this cage was on a different system. All right, we're gonna hold off the guards until Danny's done drilling.
Hey, someone's...
You gonna pull this off?
Terrible haircut. M60, 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 M60.
Yeah, good. Ooh, shotgun. I'll take that. Thanks very much.
What's he think he's doing?
That was terrible shooting. Alright, okay. There you go. See you later, pal. And you. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Taking cover! No one needs those cocksuckers!
Where's everybody else? Where is he? Alright. There. Let's keep it on.
Goddamn, we shall kick the hornet's nest this time.
Alright.
The way we walk out of here is if we get the weapon stored in that armory. Bust the door open.
I'll watch
your asses. Yeah.
My old man gonna shit a brick when he hears about this. Fuck! Fuck! Come on, help it!
Hold on, let me help you. Damn thing. Get out of the way, you got Godzilla hit. He's absolutely covered in blood, this dude. Check him out. He's a vampire. Expose the lock, rotate with L until it's green, and then press X. Right. Pull the lock, press X. Right. This is going to be interesting. Oh, look at that. Easy peasy. Gimme. Can I only carry one weapon? That really sucks. Oh, it's locked. Okay. That'll be why. No, that one, please. Oh, yeah! Check me out! The M60. That's very nice. Can I... How much health have I got? I don't think I need... Thanks very much. Anything else? No? Good.
Shit, man, these guys ain't fucking around.
Face way worse than this over in Nam. Little smoke don't mean shit. Stay close to the vault, watch for the drill. I'll deal with these assholes.
There he is.
Well, Sammy had men all over the place. One of them worked at a cleaner's and stole the uniforms Georgie Marcano and Lincoln Clay wore on the day of the robbery. Another one was a janitor at the Federal Reserve, and he provided a rough layout. The robbery of the Federal Reserve was timed perfectly, and none of it would have been possible without the involvement of Sammy Robinson, Lincoln Clay, and the rest of the black mob.
You just come from Vietnam?
That's right.
I was a Marine in the Pacific. You can take it from me. Just because you're home doesn't mean you're back. You understand? People around here, they don't get it. Never will. Keep your ass out of trouble.
Man, I wanted to play with my M60. Oh, sick. Sick. Dodge Challenger, sick.
Sorry I'm late. Got caught up crossing the bridge.
Don't worry about it.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for my stepbrother, Lincoln Clay. You seen him? He used to get ticked off if you were even a minute late.
Kiss my ass.
There he is. How was the trip?
Being how this is the first time in 4 years and somebody telling me where to go, what to do, or how to do it, it was fucking great. What's new with the old man?
Man, don't even get me started on Pops. He used to pull his head out of his ass.
Same as ever then.
Brother, you have no fucking idea.
Damn, Ellis.
Looking good.
Just like I left her.
Man, even I know not to fuck around with your car. Mm.
All right, come on. I'm ready to go home.
So those two things in 1968. The old recycling tactic was just lob it against the wall. M60. Routes. Press to open your map, then press A to your destination, blah, 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 blah. On the map, press X view chapters, L to move through prescriptions. Okay, so let's just do that. Oh, let go. So the map, right, I did actually try to show this up earlier, but it's flipping massive. The size of the beast. Absolute beast. Right, so if we want to go there. Let's drive.
So Sammy's doing all right?
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes? What if the train's delayed? What if they call him back?
Whoa.
Standing in front of the kitchen window and sipping his whiskey like he was expecting you to come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you that.
I won't.
He'll be fine once he sees you. Ever since Mama Hell, you know how he gets.
Driving is a little bit tricky. But I'll work it out. So, is that... There's a blue thing on the map. I reckon... Yeah, that's a cop. Police awareness. The police will attack you if you commit crime. Act suspiciously. You'll break traffic laws within their range of awareness. It's indicated by the blue police awareness indicator in the centre of the screen.
You remember Marty and Ron Langford?
Sure.
They moved up to Empire Bay a year or so after you shipped out. Started selling weed. They call and ask me if I want some. I say sure. It's free money as far as I'm concerned. Anyhow, a month back, Marty drops me a line and says they're moving into heroin, that they're looking for a partner down around these parts.
Can't imagine Sammy was too keen on that.
I never told him about the weed. That ain't nothing to nobody. But this, I gotta talk to him about. I ain't said more than three words and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with kids running around the neighborhood. We ain't selling no dope to no children.
Like they got any money to begin with.
Okay, that cop didn't really care that I was doing 75.
Shit. Knew a couple guys over in Nam who were running it. Wound up pissing off the wrong person. Got their throats cut.
Shit, man, I know what's what. That's why I'm talking to Georgie about it.
There's no way Sal's gonna go along with that.
Georgie says he can keep his old man from finding out. We'll steer clear of the high-low in Frisco, just selling the French wall. Georgie's Uncle Lou won't say shit as long as we give him a taste of the action.
I don't know, man. Georgie's a cool cat and all, but heroin ain't the kiddie pool.
Come in on it with us. I bet he'd agree to a three-way split.
I don't know. I kind of need to lay low a bit, figure some things out.
Yeah, all right.
Heroin ain't the kiddie pool, man. Never a true word spoken. Yeah, pink Cadillac, man.
Come on, we're going through the front. I ain't having your war hero I ask is the back door.
Okay. I'm a war hero!
Found panhandling out in front of the train station.
Pleasure, man.
Boy, I send you to bring Lincoln Clay home. Not the big nigga who ate him.
Well, shit, old man. I finally went somewhere they knew how to cook.
Welcome home, son. How are you?
I'll be better once I get some of that shine in me.
I always did love corn whiskey. I would like to make a toast. My father used to say that the real worth of a man came from the mark he left on the world. When Lincoln first told me he was joining the military, I was against it. Too dangerous, I say. Let those people fight their own war, I say. But then I realized Lincoln needed to go out and make his mark. And that's precisely what he did. I'm so proud of you. Pour Lincoln! Bienvenue à la maison!
Pour Lincoln! Bienvenue à la maison!
Bienvenue à la maison. Is that like welcome home? Yeah, it is, isn't it?
It looks so good. Nice.
Crazy priest.
Oh, I kept you in my prayers.
I really appreciate that, Father.
Now who wants to get shit-faced?
Woo! All right.
It's hard to explain.
He's aged massively.
Coming home from war. Elation. Fear. Guilt. Imagine being trapped in a dark room and there's no way out. And every fear, every nightmare you ever had is in that room with you. And there's no escape from any of it. And then one day, a door opens and you're free to go. Just like that. The thing is, you made your peace with your terror and your fear of death. And now part of you is afraid to leave it behind. But what choice do you have? Every soldier has to walk through that door, one way or another.
Man, whiskey's going hoy in the morning.
Hell, man, just sleep it off. The room's the same as you left it.
I'm gonna take the basement.
The basement? Why the fuck you wanna crash down there?
I'll see you in the morning.
Man, that wall must have really fucked you up.
Yeah, consider it, stepbrother. Go to bed. This is one of the hardest missions ever. This is level 20. Maybe if he's really drunk. He's actually going to sleep in this basement. They've got a hell of a basement, though. Look at the size of it. Maybe he wants more booze. They've got a little bit of booze still down here. Desk. Pallet. Store with a terrible light. Somewhere to hang yourself if you get bored. Ah, and a Playboy bunny. Yeah, this is why he wanted. Yeah, I get it now. He knew there was a stash down here. Oh, yeah. She looks hot. Del Rey Hollow. Oh, it's a TV as well. Horse racing on, even though it's probably like 3 in the morning. I guess they've already hooked up the to Dubai horse racing. Anyway, let's just go to bed, shall we? Sammy's. How can a priest run a bar? The Del Rey Hollow. Don't quite follow that. It's pretty intense on the storyline, though, so far. Yeah. See what I mean? And looking at the bottom left, I've got no health, no grenades. What the hell? No wallet, i.e. money. A taste. Talk to Sammy and Ellis. Okay. Horse racing still on the TV? Man, that's the 24-hour horse racing channel you got there. Still able to hang yourself? Excellent. Still can't run, but, you know, whatever. Taste the action.
We barely have 2 nickels to rub together, now we're paying for all that food. Jesus Christ!
Watch that mouth of yours.
We wouldn't be in this mess if you would have listened to me.
What mess?
It's not something you need to worry about, Lincoln. I got it under control.
Under control? God damn it, you need
to... Boy, I'm not warning you again!
Have it your way, old man!
Let him be. He needs to cool off.
You mind telling me what's got him so riled up?
We've been having problems with the Haitians. But like I say, I got it under control.
Well, truck's all loaded up. I figure we got enough out there for... Should I come back?
In honor of your returning to us safe and sound, I made a donation to Father James here. Supplied him with food he can hand out to some of our needier family.
Well, I was hoping you'd lend me a hand, Lincoln, and give you a chance to see the neighborhood.
You
This thing with the Haitians, how serious is it?
Ah, you know Ellis. Someone looks at him the wrong way, he's on them like a wet dog.
Like I said, I can come back.
Nonsense. Lincoln needs to get out. Enjoy the day. Besides, be good for the two of you to spend some time together. Gone. Those people waiting on their food.
Always with the Haitians. I don't know what happened.
I saw Langan a couple times once he was first back. He told me he wanted to leave town, head out to California. Now, he had a friend in the service who could get him a job working at the Mare Island shipyard. And the only reason he came back was to tell Sammy and Ellis goodbye. But then he found out about the trouble Sammy was having with those Haitians.
Those Haitians?
So he decided to stay and help. Those Haitians, they are bad news.
Those Haitians. Why is it always the Haitians?
No talking Langan out of it. Whatever else he might have become, Langan was always loyal.
I'm not going to get the M60, am I? They just don't want to give it to me. Teased it. They teased me with it. Warm Hearts Neighborhood Kitchen. 6 days before Mardi. Well, maybe.
Most likely. 3 month apprenticeship to start, then the union lets you in.
You tell Sammy and Ellis?
Not yet. Gonna wait a few days. Didn't want to spring it on them since I just got back.
Well, they won't like to hear it, but they'll come around. You need to do what's best for you. Go ahead and start serving those folks. I'll be back.
Serve the gumbo.
It'll be good for you to reconnect with the community. These folks missed you.
Clarence Carter. Be there. They must have paid a fortune for the licensing of this game.
Give Sammy my best, Lincoln.
Yes, sir.
There you go.
Check warm it. Meal, warm heart. Oh, sure.
There you go. Are you going to give some? All right, you can have some. There you go. Wow, this game is intense.
Hello?
Hey, how's it going? Have some food. Want some gumbo?
Real blessing here, Lincoln. Thank you.
Blessing's mine, ma'am.
Oh, look at check me out. Check me out with my little stereo spoon.
Got you working?
I'm happy to do it.
You don't look like you need free food, to be honest. Look at him. He's in, like, a proper linen suit. Seriously. Go and, like, buy your own food. All of us. I'm sorry, but the hair in this game, the Xbox, I haven't seen the PC version, but the hair, not really working out too well. Lincoln doesn't look too bad, but she... Yeah, I'm not sure what that mess is, to be honest.
Don't get old, son. It's a fucking shit show.
I'll see what I can do about that.
Hey, hello.
Hey, Cheeky.
How are you, Regine?
Nice good. Flares.
Nice to see you around the hollow again.
Nice to see those big brown eyes again.
Oh, Haitians.
We'll be over at my aunt's place.
It's those Haitians.
You should stop by.
I've got a ladle.
Megan, we got trouble.
Run, Regine.
Oh, dear.
Once we've done with you, Lincoln. Sammy's next.
Yeah! Vault cover. Left and right.
Oh my God! Shit.
Hit him.
What? Watch out!
Oh, headbutts.
You boys ought to be ashamed.
Oh, another headbutt finish. Oh! Down. That was easy. Those Haitians. What's in there? Diamonds? Heroin? Teeth. Bones. That's pretty sketchy.
Francois Papadoc Duvalier was elected president of Haiti in 1957. By 1959, he had created a secret police called Tonton Macoute, and people started to flee.
Tonton Marcoux.
Most of them settled in the southern United States. Now mixed in with the good, hard-working people were hardened criminals. They formed the backbone of what became the Haitian gang. Now Lincoln found out they set up in the swamps and were led by a man named Baca.
What a Baca.
Yeah, you and Father James done already?
We got jumped by the Haitians. It's time you level with me. Tell me what's really going on.
Yes. I suppose it is. Six, seven months ago, folks in the hollow started getting robbed. Money, jewelry, things of that nature. Didn't take long for us to figure out it was the Haitians.
Those Haitians.
And those batasses on Velour started going after the lottery.
How much money are we talking about? How much?
Enough that we're in deep shit with Sal Marcano. Haven't kicked up to him in 3 months.
Jesus Christ. If I deal with them, that gives us time to settle up with Marcano, right?
Let me worry about Sal. He and I go way back. But this thing with the Haitians...
There's Haitians.
It's time for it to end.
All right. M60, M60.
Need to handle it.
Yes, sir.
Find them.
Back in the 20s, folks used to pull salt out of the bayou. They even built themselves a little shanty town. When the Depression hit, they abandoned it. That's the only place this could have come from.
We're gonna need guns and ammo.
Call this number. But do it away from here. No sense tipping anybody off.
Or we could sweep the hollow, track down and kill every last one of those cocksuckers, then we wouldn't have to worry about it.
The last thing folks in this neighborhood need to see is colored people killing each other. Do this quiet, away from here.
Once we eliminate whoever's running the show, the rest of them will go down on their own. Trust me.
All right, soldier boy. I'll follow your lead.
Be careful, yeah? Those Haitians are a hard people.
Those Haitians.
Do not ever underestimate them.
Those Haitians.
All right, time for some action.
Action!
Que se diverse se suscite hostility.
Yeah, maybe I should put the subtitles on, because my French isn't that good to understand what on earth he just said. Let's crack into that. Let's put the subtitles on in a sec.
Those Haitians.
Come on, loading skills. Oh my, what the? Where did I get that from?
You showed us how you want.
What happened with that, man? Controls? Still. Game?
Play this.
Come on, game. Oh, let's go that way. Game. Nope. Options. Nope. Collection journal, map, kill list, back. What?
Last thing they're gonna expect is an attack from the water. You head back round to the row. Stay with the car. I'll meet you over there when this is done.
Hope you know what you're doing.
I'm loving that windscreen.
Trust me, guys. Here in a bit, this'll all be behind us.
I'm a hovercraft. You're joking. You don't want to get swimming in that. It's disgusting. Furthermore, there'll be alligators there. Wasn't much of a dive, was it? Wasn't much of a stealth entry into the water. Presumably he wasn't a Navy SEAL. when he pulled this in.
Damn! How many men we sending?
Two teams. One's going to hit the bar. The other's going after Bert.
Yeah, I got that. Get too close, make a noise, blah 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 blah. Yeah. Why don't we just look if you stay in cover until they disappear?
Boss says if we have to burn down half the hollow to get Sammy, we doing it. Ain't stopping till that old man's dead.
Oh dear.
Alice and the other one.
Lincoln Clay.
He's the one.
Lincoln Clay.
Away from us.
Uh-oh.
No sign of him over here! What are you on about? Stretches.
What?
No. Stop. Stop.
No sign of him over here!
There we go. Just gonna do this smack down this guy.
Papa Legba, open the gate for me. Atebon Legba, open the gate for me. Open the gate for me, Papa, for me to pass. When I return, I will thank the Iwa.
What the hell? In the river with you. Harsh. You didn't take... Oh, see you later, mate. That was a pretty good way of... Okay. I told you about those crocodiles, man. There's one over there. Alligators. Oh, sick. I'm going to chuck someone else in a minute. Obviously, I don't really want to spend too much time in the water. Ooh, don't mind if I do. Where should I go? Oh, this way? Yeah, that's some bro there. Three-second shakedown. No worries. Don't want a shotgun. I quite like a rifle. Where did he go? What happened to him? Where did that guy go? Okay, we'll take this guy. Let's feed the alligators. Come on. Da, 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 da. What happened to the other dude? He just disappeared. Come on. Dinner time. Ding, 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 ding. Oh, is that there? It's one way of getting rid of the evidence, isn't it? I quite like that. That's quite good. But I still only got, I've only got two weapon slots, so... Oh, it's find backer, hey? Do you think I was meant to come over this way, though? No.
Should have killed that old man a long time ago.
Think the boss was worried that Sammy would involve Marcano. Ask him to come down on us.
That cracker asshole don't give a shit about some worn-out nigga. Long as the money's coming in, Marcano don't care who's handing it to him.
All right, then. Sneak time. Duck in there, I think. Draw enemies away to thin out the group. I don't really need to thin out the group at the moment. Maybe I can just sneak up on that bro without walking into the table. Let's try it.
Huh?
Oh! What was that 30 Alfred? I'm just going to chuck him in here just in case someone turns up. He's gone for sleep. Okay. Won't feed the crocodiles. It's alligators! This time around. Oh my days, there's loads of them. This one's talking about thinning out the herd.
Fidodo, petty po mama. Fidodo, petty po mama. Si baby pa fidodo. Granulo va manje. Granulo va manje.
Okay.
Si baby pa fidodo. Granulo va manje.
Oh. Got my buttons all messed up then. Right, okay, I can see them in the mini map. He's going the other way. Nice bit barbed wire there. Man, I'm the sneakiest ninja in history. I am Captain Sneaky. Alfredson. That is the old pistol Alabra. So let's just take out this guy, right? Because I'm going to try and eliminate the herd with my amazing strangling technique. This guy's freaking blind as. Choking everybody out. Choke cold. Okay, and this guy is suitably stupid.
Wouldn't have been bad if they got the motherfucker.
Oh, he's got like a little damage rating. Damage, accuracy, rate of fire. Let's swap out for that one. That one's got loads better damage, but I've only got 5 rounds. Can't see my elbow, obviously. Awesome. Let's crack that one out. Oh, the Thompson! Let's just see what he does with the old pistol Arbra. Ow. That would wreck. I mean, seriously wreck. Thompson. Ow. That would also wreck. Kick door. There we go, on a kick door. This seems like a way better prospect. I've got loads more bullets with it.
You dishonor your alpha command. Fuck you! You come to take my life!
Get your ass now!
Oh, death to you.
Fuck you.
Those Haitians.
Fuck you.
You made a big mistake going after the Hollow.
The Hollow? That's why he's just a coward. That's why it's all. Fuck me. That was not too white, man.
The man you're talking about took me in when I had nowhere else to go.
You are no better than him.
Oh! Murderous moves. Who's that? Oh. Love interest, love interest. Beep, beep, beep.
You can't take those shows! You fucking pig! Damn you to her!
Take it easy!
Take it easy! Take it easy! He kept me in there, locked in there, day and night. Beat me. Use me! I kiss you, motherfucker! You and your entire goddamn family!
He's dead! He's dead! He can't hurt you anymore. It's over.
Over? Over! This is never going to be over. Pajam!
Fucking Haitians.
What have I got here? Nines, knives. Whoa! Aim a Molotov. Release a Molotov. Can't even actually see them particularly. Ah, he's on fire!
Fuck, I won't stop shooting!
I can't hear shit! Well, I hit him that time. Thompson Aurelio. Right, where am I going? Bit more ammo. Hopefully they've got loads of ammo. Oh, there's a Molotov. Another Molotov.
Only yourself to blame for me.
Okay, that was a little bit excessive in terms of. No witnesses. Aha! Critical injuries. Need some health.
We ain't stopping till we find you, bruh!
I did say something about an adrenaline shot. But I missed that bit. Also do. Ooh, hello.
I'll put one in his ear!
You swap weapons and it reloads automatically, which is quite fortuitous. No witnesses.
Him.
Finish him.
Come and get me, Coson. Quite like to get up there, really.
Thank Christ.
Get over there and look.
We ain't.
How many bullets does that guy want to take? Right, that's an amazing Sig 9 there. Boy, it's a Czech BR. I don't really have very much ammo.
Ridiculous.
Oh, hello. Just gonna say hello to my Czech friend. I think.
Another one down. We ain't stopping till we find you, bro.
What? Shoot him!
Move to the other side!
It's shot! Yeah.
Getting low!
Throw Molotov at him!
Bastard!
Oh, that was good. Yeah, I heard you coming, pal. I'm feeling that, but I've probably got...
See him? I'm doing a Molotov!
Okay, go on then. I'm gonna blow you away with a frickin' epic Czech pistol.
That must have fucking caught some sins.
Bastard's gonna burn! Watch out!
Okay, I've got two.
Out of bullets! Gotta reload!
I've got two bullets left. I've got two Molotov cocktails as well. Where is this guy? There he is.
Target practice starts now.
Don't think about it. Shoot
Throw
him!
A Molotov!
See him? I'm throwing a Molotov!
Another one!
You can have a Molotov as well. I can aim it. Oh, that's my brother!
It starts now.
I'll be there.
About fucking time.
Give me a moment.
Let me in. Where you going? Where you going?
Hold yourself to blame for me.
Oh my days. Let's get the smeg out of here.
Always gotta get you out of trouble, don't I?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I am. How'd it go with Baca?
We came to an understanding. He stayed dead, not let him. Let's get back to Sammy's.
Can't even tell you how happy Pops is gonna be. Man, this shit with the Haitians has been weighing on him.
With them out the way, things will calm down. Go back to the way they should be.
Been telling him for months we needed to do something like this, but Pops, he... I don't know. Sometimes I think he's lost the taste for this shit.
Just because a man don't rush to violence don't mean he lost something.
I know, just makes me wonder what happens after, you know?
No, I don't know. Explain it to me.
Don't matter if it's a bullet or the hand of God. We all go sometime, right?
I suppose. But Ellis, we don't need to talk about...
I pray that Pops outlives the both of us. But if he doesn't...
Oh,
he's gonna be looking to us or gunning for us. Just saying we gotta be ready when that day comes.
Yeah, well, that's not something we gotta worry about right now. So just cool it with your grand plans, all right?
Yeah, all right.
Well, I can beat people out of the way. Yeah, go through!
The world wasn't always this confusing. Folks knew their place.
No, don't ram me. Dude.
what was right.
Oh, hello.
Things were just easier, and people were just happier. Back in those uncomplicated days, there was time for family and friends and simple pleasures, like dinner conversations. The kind you can still have at the Briar Patch.
Yeah, the Briar Patch.
Back in time, to a world that was just a little bit simpler. The Briar Patch. Good food, good folks, good old-fashioned Southern hospitality.
Hey, Felicia.
Oh. Whoops.
Isn't it out of sight?
I was there as well.
White patent leather thighs. Where'd you get them?
Like, oh, he's made it.
Houghton's? I didn't know they had such far-out friends. They carry all kinds of groovy styles for men and women. Really? I also got this mock turtleneck dick.
Yeah, whatever.
You need to watch where you're going.
Shut your face.
Well, look at you.
I'm meant to go in there or in there. I'm here. Well, you're right. All right.
Vang Lincoln didn't understand, or maybe want to understand, is that for a man like Sammy, there's always gonna be more Haitians. Now, if there wasn't someone going after Sammy, then there was someone else forcing him into a bad situation. It was never going to end. That's how Mankin ended up working for Sal Marcano.
You were right about those Haitians being down by that old salt mine. They won't be bothering us again.
It was a mistake sending you down there. I should handle my own business.
This isn't any different than what I was doing before I left.
You probably don't know this. But every night on the TV, right after the news, they show the names of all the boys killed over there in Vietnam. I'd be sitting in the kitchen eating my supper, watching that list scroll by, wondering if today is the day I finally see your name.
But you never did. Nothing happened to me.
There's only so much luck down the well. Sooner or later, pull up that bucket, there's nothing in it.
So, what are we gonna do about Marcano?
Pay him his goddamn money one way or the other.
Lottery gonna be enough to cover it?
The lottery? No. But Sal called a bit ago. Wants you to meet him up the country club. Says he's got something in the works. Square things up between us.
The only black folk allowed in there to help.
Now, they may not like it, but they're not gonna say no to Sal Marcano. He says you get to come in, you get to come in.
Fine. Always did want to see the inside of that place.
You need to do whatever Sal asks, yeah? For all our sakes.
Yes, sir.
Sir, yes, sir. All right, I'm back in a smoke.
Native son, dear listener.
Thank you very much.
It was a much needed break because old Remy had to put a little more
jive to the reduced yacht club. So guys, I think I am gonna, me and Lincoln are gonna leave you here. I guess this episode is probably about an hour long. Not sure you guys are still watching, but you never know. If you are, thank you so much, you're still here. I think the storyline is actually really interesting and pretty cool. It's quite slow paced, but in a way that's quite good. Oh, look, I'm kind of like, oh, I'll step here, and I'll step there. Anyway, obviously it'll expand out as time goes on, the bigger weapons, the more people, the more storyline, but you know what, I will do another episode very, very soon, very, very shortly. If you guys are still watching, please hit the like button, also subscribe, there'll be plenty more content, there's loads of open world RPG games on this channel, and I'm sure you'll enjoy the content if you like that sort of thing, but again, Thank you so much for watching. Watch out for the next episode, which should be very, 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 very soon. Any feedback, any comments, anything, whatever you want to say, stick it in those things they call the comments below, obviously. And, yeah. Hopefully, I'll see you in the next one. Take it easy now. No expense in strutting our stuff.